Hi, I'm Paul Wells from Agile J. Java, what is it and what problem does it solve? Well, the problem is there are a number of different platforms. Sometimes they have different hardware, always they have different operating systems. On each of these operating systems there is an API. You write your program up here and talk to the API, which is fine, except that when you want the same program to run on a different operating system, the API is different. And so you have to modify your code up here in order to make it work with the new API. And again on this platform, and again on this platform. So what happened was that these guys here realized that people were writing their applications for this platform, and the effort it took to write it for this platform, it wasn't worth it. So the whole industry was going down a route of just writing applications for one platform. So they came up with an idea. Well, the solution is in principle something very simple. Instead of having every application talk to the API, let's put another layer in between and let that layer talk down to the API. So one of those arrows might be talking to the file system, one might be the threading model, one might be the user interface. And then build one of these things, called a virtual machine, that can then go and live on each of these platforms. Okay, so now we're in the situation that what we've got is a collection of virtual machines covering each platform, and now it's a simple matter of writing your application up here against this standardized API, which is the same in all cases. So this is the famous write once, run everywhere. Now Java itself is obviously a whole new programming language, and there are other parts to it which I will explain in other videos, but the basic essence of it is let's have a single layer which can be used to standardize talking to multiple operating systems. Now what's actually very good about this arrangement is, yes, you can run your application on lots of different operating systems. You can also, as new operating systems come along in the future, you don't have that much work to do to support those operating systems. But where you're into internet browsers, then you can actually write little applications that run in a browser, and without needing to know which operating system the browser is running on, then you can deploy web-based applications and it will run on different browsers running on different machines. And this was the birth of the applet. So you've got to remember here, I'm talking about 12 years ago, and this was seen as a way to open up the web and make it possible to deploy applications that run in a browser. Well, in reality, applets didn't catch on. The main reason for that was that this thing here, even though it was only a few megabytes on the internet 10 years ago, that could take 10 or 20 minutes to download. Nobody wants to wait that long for a web page to open and to start working. Java lives on. It lives on in desktop applications and certainly on the server. The reason, though, is not because of its platform independence, I have to say, mainly because it's a very productive programming language.